From old little town of Bethlehem to It Came Upon the Midnight Clear. Join us as we trace world-famous American Christmas carols back to their humble beginnings. And within this tradition, we present a spectacular performance of brand new American Christmas carols and favorite songs to celebrate the wonders of Christmas. With over 16 million Americans serving our country overseas during World War II, there were countless letters sent home to America from far-off, treacherous battlefields by family members and friends separated by the global conflict. So when Christmas came in the early 1940s, many families could not celebrate together at home. It was in the middle of the war that lyricist Tim Janis from Brooklyn, New York, crafted the heartfelt poem, I'll Be Home for Christmas. His words captured the hope of so many Americans who wished for nothing more than to rejoin their families and friends on Christmas during this difficult time. New York-born composer Walter Kent set the poem to music in 1943, and later that year, Bing Crosby's recording of the song became a major hit, especially among American soldiers. In honor of all Americans who serve and are currently serving our country, we present three new American Christmas carols that celebrate being home for Christmas and the joys of the Christmas celebration.
Rejoice in our Savior's birth.
In a small town in New England in 1849, when the long snowy winters kept people huddled around the fire, the lyrics for the Christmas carol, It Came Upon the Midnight Clear, were written by Reverend Edmund Sears. After graduating from Harvard Divinity School, Sears spent most of his life living and working in the wooded rural communities of Wayland in western Massachusetts. Composer Richard Willis, who set It Came Upon the Midnight Clear to music, was based in New York City and worked as a critic and editor for the New York Tribune. Willis had studied composition from the famous European composer Felix Mendelssohn. The efforts of Sears and Willis resulted in the creation of one of the first American Christmas carols to gain international recognition. In tribute to their accomplishments, we present three new American Christmas carols that express the wonders of Christmas.
Savior's birth, rejoice, sleeping, God breaks through the darkest night, bringing hope to all creation, and pouring out His love with His light. Oh God, with us on the earth, rejoice in our Savior's birth. Rejoice, rejoice, for the Lord has come. The Lord.
Horizon is filling sky.
while the earth lay sleeping, and the glory of the Lord filled the heaven, and a king was born who is called Wonderful.
Surrounded by the busy atmosphere of New York City in 1857, John Henry Hopkins, a 37-year-old music instructor at the General Theological Seminary, devoted himself to many pursuits. In addition to teaching at the seminary, the University of Vermont graduate designed stained glass windows and edited a magazine entitled Church Journal. In the midst of his diverse activities, he wrote the classic American Christmas carol, We Three Kings of Orient Are. The song grew in popularity in America and abroad, and was featured in the 1871 book entitled Christmas Carols, New and Old, published in England. In the tradition of Hopkins' timeless Christmas carol, we present three modern songs that celebrate the treasured moments of Christmas.
Creation sings, oh star of wonder, holy night. wise men seeking truth traveled from afar, hoping to find the child from heaven, falling on their knees, bowed before the humble
Prince of Peace.
I bring an offering of worship to my King. No one on earth deserves the praises that I sing. Jesus, may you receive the honor that you're due. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. I bring an offering. Jesus, may you receive the honor that you're due. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you.
In the esteemed halls of the White House, on February 17, 1882, the President of the United States, Chester Arthur, was brought to tears by an emotional performance of the Fisk University Jubilee Singers. These groundbreaking singers were on a world tour to raise money for Fisk University, and in doing so, brought spirituals to the world stage. During that time period, the documenting, composing, and arranging work of two American scholars, Frederick Jerome Work and his brother, John W. Work II, helped make the emotional Christmas spiritual Go Tell It on the Mountain available to the Fisk University Jubilee Singers, preserving this treasured composition for generations to come. In tribute to their valuable work, we present three new American carols inspired by the events of Christmas.
Sing glory to
gracious Redeemer, Jesus my Savior, ever I love you, ever I love you. Shepherds and angels are bowing before you, gazing upon your lovely.
Imagine being over 5,000 miles away from America in 1865, riding horseback through the deserts of the Middle East to reach the small town of Bethlehem on Christmas Eve. The American minister, Phillips Brooks, was fortunate enough to take this long journey all the way from his church in Philadelphia. When he finally arrived in Bethlehem, he was incredibly moved seeing the Christmas celebration at the Church of the Nativity. Taking in this experience, he wrote the lyrics for the classic American Christmas carol, O Little Town of Bethlehem, which he first shared with the Sunday school students back in Philadelphia. The organist from his church, Louis Redner, wrote the music for the carol the night before it was first performed on Christmas Day in 1868. In the spirit of their composition, we close with a collection of new and classic Christmas carols and songs from America and beyond.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till He appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices, oh, now.
You're the one we worship.
You're the one we love. We adore you. We adore you. We adore you, Jesus. We adore you. We adore you. We adore you.
And the cry.